Along the lines, we lose ourselves. And life is there to remind us.
Joanna! Your sister doesn't understand yet. Give her more time. I know, love. Just give her more time.
I heard the poet pouring essence into a room.
Strength. Crawling out a grave of deep-rooted destruction with nothing but the affection of self-worth. Covered in mud, gasping for life, break the surface and become new, a rebirth. Courage. Sink your teeth into reality, tasting the magic of all you wish to accomplish. Seasoned with strife, tender with failure, let your dreams emerge and survive. Flawless, resilient, enough to withstand the blow of 10,000 tongues tormenting the tenacity of your existence. But like carbon pressed 100 miles deep comes a diamond when it reaches the surface. Power, the thunder of 1,000 elephants running full force. Demons quiver with every step you take because you have what they can never get back, the true love of God and your royal estate. Robust, suited in an armor constructed by the very God who sends the wind and squeezes the clouds for rain. You howl to God, snot dripping from your nose, for the very strength that you already obtained.
The room felt empty. Even though I watched them gulp their beers and spewed empty words at each other, she spoke the tongues of life that the only ones who desire growth could understand. Like me, she spoke to a crowd on a different frequency, which made me wonder why. Why put on a show when they won't understand?
Sleep on me. Feel the rhythm in my chest, just breathe. I will stay, so the lantern in your heart won't fade. The secrets you tell me, I'll take to my grave. There's bones in my closet, but you hang stuff anyway. And if you have nightmares, we'll dance on the bed. I know that you love me, even when I lose my head. Guillotine. Guillotine. Even when I lose my head. Guillotine.
I had watched her dance, watched her dress twirl and twist. She was breathtaking. Her dance spoke to me. Her dance told a story of love and self-acceptance. I understood her. I wanted her to join me for a night of endless expression. but maybe she won't understand me. I wasn't worried if they didn't show. Watching them made me realize one thing I had forgotten. Though I am less than the least of all the saints, this grace was given to me to preach the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Christ. Ephesians 3:8. This was something my mother would say when the frustration of not being able to communicate to others would cloud my mind. Once again, I felt that frustration, but my goal, to encourage others to express the way that their Creator had designed to, was still alive because they were my reminder that I am unmuted.
Thank you.